So tell us about your home visiting program. Yeah. What is it?
So home visiting is bringing to parents, journeying with parents from prenatal till they're 3 years old. We come with a curriculum of health, well-being, and school readiness. When you change the first 5 years of a child's life, you change everything. This is where we help parents be the best they can be, because a parent is the primary caregiver and primary educator of their child. And we know if a child is in a program like home visiting, they arrive at kindergarten ready to take advantage of the big investment of K through 12.
So who comes to the home?
So we have trained home visitors. These are people with a background in education and in health. And so the home visitor is assigned to this family, and they journey with that family through the 3 years. Every week, there they are with them, answering their questions, bringing this curriculum. But we also have something special in our program, which most home visiting programs don't. We have enhanced referral. The average family that comes to us has 6 referral needs. It could be transportation, housing, food insecurity, insurance coverage, and we connect them to the resources. We teach them how to advocate for themselves and for their child. And once you stabilize them, then they can take advantage of the curriculum. But every family, no matter what ethnic or economic background they come from, they can benefit from home visiting.
How do you get into the program?
So if you want to be in the program for St. Joseph, you just have to call us. You can go to our website, and you'll be placed into a lottery. Because we're at capacity, we're visiting 600 homes a week. We're at the capacity that we can serve, and we're privately funded from our own trust. We don't take any government money. So we have a $90 million trust that's dedicated just for New Mexico for home visiting that we use that belongs to St. Joseph. So our services are free. We're the largest home visiting program in the nation of this type. And so we also have satellites in 6 counties in New Mexico that we serve. Okay. But if you want to be in the program, they'll put you in the lottery, and we hope you win because you want to win the lottery.
Yeah. And what is the benefit of this?
So the benefit of this is a child's health. We talk about health, well-being, and school readiness. The best practices, what are the evidence-based practices for raising your child? So for instance, we have measurable outcomes that we look for, that the baby is born at a healthy birth weight. You want to eliminate the neonatal intensive care, the need for that. We decrease the need for a visit to the emergency room because of that safety. We increase immunization, the health of the baby, creating a medical home with a pediatrician. And then what the parents need to be doing with the baby, preparing them for school, reading to them from very young age. Reading is all about vocabulary, and vocabulary is about a baby's interaction with an adult and that language, that meaningful language. But in New Mexico, we're suffering from toxic stress, an epidemic of toxic stress. We rank number 1 in children living in poverty in the nation. We're the 2nd highest of children living in hunger in the nation. We have to solve these issues, and together, home visiting with the parents, we address the issues and we journey with them.
What could you say to someone who's like, oh, I don't need help?
Yeah.
But like, everybody needs help. I just had a baby. If you want
to be an expert at something, you got to go for training, you got to go to school, you got to go to college, and most people have not been educated on how do you raise a baby. The most important thing that someone can do is raising a baby. It's not just instinct. There are right practices and there are wrong practices. And that's why with home visiting, we want you to have the right practices, the evidence-based practices of what you do in caring for your child. So that way your child will succeed. And evidence shows us, and that's very clear. You can see that from the pediatricians. You can see that from James Heckman, Nobel Prize winning economist, and his research, that if a child goes through home visiting the parents, because it's about the parents, that child will be reading at grade level at 3rd grade. And evidence tells us, if you read at grade level at 3rd grade, you graduate. This is where we turn around the whole state. Now, this is a long effort that we have to do to turn New Mexico around. If we're going to attract the right jobs, we got to have the right workforce. And where does that workforce begin? It begins in those first 3 years of life. 3 important things that we can show that studies have said. Someone who's in a program, a child develops self-control, self-awareness, and delayed gratification by the time you're 3 years old. If you can't master that, you will never graduate from anything. This is what takes place in home visiting. Their health, but also the social dynamics of dealing with delayed gratification if you're going to have success. This is developed in the brain very, very early as a little baby.
Can you give us some examples of some of the exercises or conversations that happen when these people go do these home
visits? Yeah. So the home visitor will come in. They ask, how was your week? How did you to report? Did you have an appointment with either, let's say, WIC or with a doctor? And we record that. We keep track of that. And then they deliver a curriculum. So, for instance, let's say it's about teething, what you should do, not do. Let's say this is about potty training. Or early on, when am I moving the baby from milk to solid foods? And how should I do those solid foods? And how do I find out what my baby likes? One woman who graduated from our program after the 3 years, she said, you helped me know my baby. They're baby whisperers, and they're trained and educated, but they'll journey with you and find what's right for you.
Okay. And then the study that just came out, said, you know, it looks like they studied New Mexico families, this Journal of Pediatric Medicine, and they said that, you know, families who are part of these programs are one-third less likely to visit the ER. You mentioned
yes.
that the first.
So if you're in a program like this, what's happening is a parent's stress level is coming down. So you're not having the threat of abuse happening there. But then also for accidents, you know, for a little baby, you get down on your knees and it's a whole different world. How are we preventing accidents? And then also for prevention on illnesses that are very preventable with hygiene and other things like that. And this is what the pediatricians are talking about. That if our babies are in a program like this, the parents become the best that they can be. And here's the multiplier effect. If we invest, this is called social investment. If we invest in these parents, the following children they have will benefit from this education of the parent. You hear about an infant mental health. And this is something that the pediatricians talk about also. And when I first heard that, I thought, well, that sounds crazy. I thought of a baby laying on a psychiatrist's couch. But if the baby could talk, what would the baby be saying? The baby would be saying, Doc, it's my parents. They just don't get me. Yeah. We want parents to get them.
Right. 600 homes a week in New Mexico.
Yes. That's well, 600 homes in three counties in the metropolitan area.
Oh, the metro area.
In the metro area.
Okay.
Now, you have to remember, there's 27,000 firstborns a year. So the need is greater than what we do. And there's other programs who contract with the state that are important. But a great portion of the home visiting in New Mexico is done by private organizations. We don't take any government money, but we advocate for those who do, and that the state needs to step up and fund their part.
Okay. If people are interested, I mean, do they have a good chance of getting in, or is it a pretty long
list? It's about a 50-50. Now, there's no waiting list. If you want to get in, you're immediately, within 2 weeks, placed in the lottery. And there's about a 50-50 chance that you would be able to enter. So you want to try. And you want to try early. You know,
right.
The best time to come in is in prenatal.
Yeah.
Because in prenatal, they'll prepare the parents for what to expect when they're going to have the baby. The mother's nutrition, you know, folic acid, taking the vitamins that she needs to be on. And then also hoping that we're going to help the mother avoid any depression. A natural occurring thing that happens after having a baby. To get through that. And then learning also about breastfeeding. Mm-hmm. Breastfeeding is a hard thing and it doesn't come natural for everyone.
Yeah, it's really hard. No one tells you.
No, it's a very difficult thing.
Until you try.